This is Shannon Deskins reporting. As we've been alluding to this morning, we thought we would be here as the Pikeville Fire Department took steps to close one of the floodgates in Pikeville. We knew that 38 feet was that magic number, and Paul Maynard, Public Safety Director for the city, we have finally hit that 38-foot mark.
Yes, we finally got a reading of 38.1, which is when we erect this gate. Obviously, the other gate doesn't get erected to 50 feet, so the decision was made quickly. We already had a crew on standby. They're here, and they're in the process of putting that gate up now.
Okay. Now, what this means for you if you're traveling anywhere in the city of Pikeville is that the bypass road that's going to go in front of Pikeville High School is now closed at that point of where you can get up on US 23. So it's closed at the Lower Bowles Addition on one side and then here at the Middle Bowles on the other. So traffic cannot pass through anymore.
Yeah, they still have access to the ramp. They'll be able to get off of the bypass if they're heading, I guess, northbound. They'll still be able to get to the ram, but they will not have flow through to get through the gate to go on towards Pikeville High School.
Now let's talk about this process that's going on behind me. I mean, it's taking, we've got a couple dozen men here working on that. All this is stored in a building over there, but they're putting it up. And this isn't something they do very often. This is the second time this has only happened.
Yeah, exactly. In the history of the floodgate, since it's been here since the cut-through project, this is the second erection of it. The first one was back in 2015 when we crested at 42 feet. But what people don't realize is we do drills on this gate as well. At least once or twice a year, they'll bring all the guys down. They go through it. That way, when we do get in a situation like this, it goes pretty seamlessly. They get it up very quickly. And the citizens should know that these guys are just, they're highly trained individuals. They really get the job done, and we're really proud of them.
All right. So just to let you know, flood stage in the city of Pikeville for the Leviosa Fork is 35 feet at 38 feet. That's when we said earlier that action was going to happen, and that action is going on now. We've hit 38.1, I believe, in the 12 o'clock reading.
Mm-hmm. 38.1. We're anticipating a 39.6 crest. But what people need to realize, even though we hit that crest mark, this gate won't come down. It'll stay there until the river dramatically drops. And the reason we do that, you never know what could happen. You know, later on tonight, tomorrow, what have you, if that river level is still up around 38, we may take another rain and would cause us just to come right back out and put it back up. So as a precautionary measure, it stays in place till we get that dramatic drop in the river.
All right, so two things to remember. The river has not crested yet in Pikeville. We're at 38 feet. But the big thing is if you're traveling in Pikeville, you're not going to be able to pass through this overpass to access Pikeville High School on the bypass. Again, traffic can get up on off 23, but they just can't come through anymore. So I think we're going to step out of the way, let these guys finish what they're doing. But a historic day. Like we said, this has only happened. This is the second time this has only happened. This has happened ever so. We're going to continue to film this, and we'll bring this story to you later. But just remember, high water is still happening. The rain right now has stopped, but just continue to watch the water. I'm Shannon Deskins reporting in Pikeville.